स्टार्ट में
गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑल ऑफ यू वेलकम बैक टू आवर लाइव ऑनलाइन वेबिनार क्लास फॉर इंटरमीडिएट स्टूडेंट्स इन प्रीवियस सेशंस वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट दी सम एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स एंड देयर फंक्शंस ओके व्हाट आर दैट हाइपोथैलेमस पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड एंड नेक्स्ट वन पीनियल ग्लैंड एंड थायराइड ग्लैंड ओके इन टुडे क्लास we will discuss about the next further continuation of the endocrine glands thyroid gland after completion of the structure of the thyroid gland and the hormones which are released from the thyroid gland today now we will enter into the what are the disorders of thyroid hormone thyroid hormone what are the disorders means here two types of the secretions we will observe what are that hyposecretions and hypersecretion hypo means what lower secretion of the thyroid hormone hyper means higher secretions so here we can observe the two types of the secretions from the thyroid gland what are that hypo and hypersecretion what are the symptoms of hyposecretion of this thyroid hormone means here in the congenital stage means by birth which type of the diseases we will observe now here when the woman is in the pregnant condition if thyroid hormone is low when the thyroid hormone is in lower condition what are the symptoms means here baby is with the mentally retarded what is that students mentally retarded condition we will observe in the congenital means by birth and weak muscles and stress they did not respond into the stress and some other characters like laziness like that okay mentally retarded children are born from the hyposecretion of this thyroid hormone when adult condition this woman is in the adult condition what we observe means generally we observe the puffy face okay the swelling on the face and next the muscles are not properly distributed some fat like substances look like in this muscle okay and some more condition what are that is important one irregular menstrual cycle what is that irregular menstrual cycles okay we already know every month we will know about the menstrual periods so when this thyroid hormone secretion is in the abnormal condition we observe irregular menstrual cycles okay and next what we'll observe puffy face okay swelling like situation in the face okay and the bones are not properly work with the muscles irregular contractions of the muscles we will observe now. Okay these are the what is that by birth congenital stage and when the adult woman that woman is going to the adult stage they are the situations in the congenital means by birth we will observe the which type of condition mentally retarded children are born in the adults what is the major situation irregular menstrual cycles puffy face like that okay irregular contractions on the muscles like most of the painful situations in the muscles like that okay next and some cases it leads to sterility what is that sterility means they did not available for the reproduction they did not give the birth to the children in some cases that nothing but the sterility what is that sterility and next in some places in the food, what will happen? Iodine molecules are low in the salt. In the salt. Which molecule, students? Iodine molecules are low in the salt. That type of situation is called simple goiter. What is that? Simple goiter. Means the swelling we will show into these neck regions. The type of people neck is into the swelling mode. Why? Because salt did not have a iodine molecules. This iodine is useful for the absorption of the thyroxine. Absorption of the thyroxine. Okay, here in the salt, the iodine also very important. The type of situation is called as simple goiter. Okay, and here the type of disease, when the hypo or hypersecretions is come, the type of situation is called Graves' disease. What is that here? Simple goiter. And another one, what is that? Graves' disease. Another important character for this Graves' disease means the protruded eyes. The eyes are coming from their locations. Okay, the protruded eyes are seen in this Graves' disease, and simple goiter also related for the thyroid gland secretion, abnormal secretion. Okay, this is all about the thyroid gland, and next we will discuss about the another gland, the thymus. What is that? Thymus gland. Okay, students. Next one, thymus gland. Where it located? Near the heart. Near to the heart. Near to the heart. When the sternum region is presented, here we will observe the one gland, nothing but the, what is that? Thymus gland. Okay, here. Thymus gland. Okay, here, what are the secretions from this thymus gland? Means what are the hormones coming from this thymus gland? The nothing but the thymosine. What is that, students? Thymosine. Near the heart, we will observe the one endocrine gland, the nothing but the thymus gland. Thymus gland secretes the hormone, that is the thymosine. Okay, what is the function of this thymosine? Means here it acts on the T lymphocytes. What is that? T lymphocytes. Where the T lymphocytes are were? In the immunity. Where, students? Immunity. Here T lymphocytes are the important, and it is stimulated by the thyroxine hormone, which is released from the thymus gland. Okay, here in the birth, here three types of the situations we will observe for this thymus gland. For example, the children, in the children's infancy state. In the children, the thymus gland activity is very high. That's why we will give the vaccines to the children. Why? Because here it works on the immunity. When the puberty is come, it automatically sinks. Automatically sinks. When the puberty is come, it automatically starts the sinks. After the old age, means after the puberty, when the old age is come, it totally disappears. May chance to totally disappears. That's why old people does not have a proper immunity. Okay, but in the children, what will we show? They are have a higher immunity levels. That's why we give the vaccine for the childhood only. That's why this thymus gland is called childhood gland. Childhood gland. It active and it gives secretions on the immunity in the childhood. The step of the secretions, thymosin. What is that? Thymosin. Okay, it acts on the immunity. Okay, students, the next we will go to another endocrine gland, which is the backside of on the thyroid gland. That is nothing but the parathyroid gland. What is that? Parathyroid. Parathyroid gland. Okay, here. Where they are located means, for example, we already know about this thyroid gland. Between the sternum and tracheal region. So, here it is the ventral view of the thyroid gland. And for example, it is a thyroid gland. It is a ventral view and it is a dorsal view. In the dorsal side of the thyroid gland, we observe the four parathyroid glands. Means two pairs of the parathyroid glands we will observe backside of the thyroid gland. Okay, what is the importance of this parathyroid glands? It look like a buttons, shut buttons, look like a shut button. What are the importance of this parathyroid gland? Means here, the parathyroid gland secretes the parathormone. What is that, students? Parathormone. Okay, what is that? It secretes the parathormone. And cortisol also. Parathormone and cortisol are the secretions of the parathyroid gland. Where it locates? The ventral view of the, sorry, dorsal view of the thyroid gland. What will happen if the secretions of the parathyroid gland is losses and abnormal secretions of the parathyroid gland? Means here, for example, it is a bone of the human. In previous session, we learned about this. What is that? The higher amount of the calcium in the blood, for example, you take a calcium rich food in that day. Higher amount of the calcium is released into this blood. Okay, next, what will happen? This blood is deposited into the bones of our body. Okay, next, in this condition, what will happen means, when the calcium level is low on your blood, here from the bone, the calcium is resorbed. What will happen? Resorbed means demineralization of bone is takes place. Remineralization of bone is takes place. What will happen? Remineralization of the bone means here lower amount of the calcium is presented in the blood. So what will happen? Bone will demineralize the calcium and it fix into the blood. It give opposite action to the, which one? All of you remember? Which one, students? Calcitonin. What is that? Calcitonin. And these parathyroid hormones are give separate, means anti-actions. One hormone is important for the fixation of the calcium in the blood and another hormone is important for the fix the calcium level into the bone. They are the opposite functions. Okay, what will happen if this parathormone is lack or loses their function? Means here the involuntary and painful contractions of muscles are takes place. Involuntary and painful contractions in the muscles that nothing but the spasm. What is that, student? Spasm. The painful involuntary contractions of the muscles are called as spasm. Okay, the type of situation is called tetany. What is that? Tetany. Okay, so it is called as a hypercalcemic hormone. Hypercalcemic hormone. Why? Because it secretes the demineralizes the bone, means higher amount of the calcium is fixed into the blood. Okay, here the condition is called as tetany. What is that, student? Tetany. Here also we will show the irregular menstrual periods and irregular contractions of the muscles, painful situations in the muscles like that. They are the situations of the parathyroid gland. What is that? Parathyroid gland and their hypo or hyper secretions of that hormone. Then next, we will enter into the another gland, nothing but the, what is that? Adrenal gland. Adrenal gland. Where the adrenal gland is located? Means it's located on the upper portion of the kidney. Upper portion of the kidney. Okay. It is also called suprarenal gland. Adrenal. Renal means which one? The portion of the kidney. Okay. Here it presented in the upper position of the kidney. Adrenal gland. Here, adrenal gland is in two types of the origins. It shows the two types of the origins. What are they? Means mesosomal and ectodermal. Mesodermal and ectodermal origins. Means in the adrenal gland, we will observe the two types of the portions. What are there? We will see now. Okay. For example, it is a adrenal gland. Here, cortex region is present. Adrenal cortex. Here, medulla is present. Cortex, medulla region. This is the cortex region and it is a medullary region. This medullary region is linked with the nervous system, neurohypophysis. Medullary means what? It links with the nervous system, neurohypophysis. But here, cortex region is again separated into three zones. What are there? Means zona glomerulosa. What is that, students? Zona glomerulosa. Next one. Zona fasciculata. Zona fasciculata. And another one. Third one. Zona reticularis. Here, for example, it is a cortex region. We will observe the three types of the layers. What are there? Zona glomerulosa, zona fasciculata, and zona reticularis. These are the three layers present in the cortex region of the adrenal gland. And here, the cortex means adrenal gland secretes the corticoids. What is that? Corticoids, very important. Three types of the corticoids. What are they? Means glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids, and last one, sex corticoids. Okay, here three types of the corticoids. We will observe. What are that? Glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids, and sex corticoids. Okay. Here three zones are we will observe and learn in detail. First zone, zona glomerulosa. What is that? Zona glomerulosa. Here, it secretes the glucocorticoid. The major corticoid, for example, aldosterone. What is the best example for this? Aldosterone. Okay, what is the function of aldosterone? Means it regulates the glucose function. Okay, glucose enolysis, proteolysis, lipolysis. Okay, it works on that conditions. Aldosterone is the major corticoid releasing from this zona glomerulosa, and it works on the glucose functioning means glucolysis, proteolysis, lipolysis. Means their secretion and their generation. That is very, very important. And next zone, zona fasciculata. What is that, student? Zona fasciculata. Here we will observe the mineralocorticoids. Okay, what is that? Mineralocorticoids. Okay, students. Okay, here cortisol. Cortisol is the major hormone which is released from the fasciculator. Means which fasciculator? Zona fasciculator. So here it is a glucocorticoid. Glucocorticoid. This zona glomerulosa releases the mineralocorticoid. Nothing but the aldosterone. Aldosterone. But here, zona fasciculata releases the glucocorticoid. The best example for this glucocorticoid is nothing but cortisol. What is that? Cortisol. Okay. Next, we will observe these functions. What is that? Aldosterone and cortisol functions in a detail. Okay. Here. First one, what is that, student? Aldosterone. Okay. What is the major function and how it is work? Means here, when you are in a dehydration condition or in a unconscious mode. What will happen means here this aldosterone is released from this glomerulosa and it gives the, what is that? Na plus and K plus functioning. How it is work? Means here sodium ions used to the cells for the dehydration or unconscious situation. Means here BP is low. Your BP is low. Okay. What will happen? Body need the sodium ions. So this aldosterone gives the sodium ions to the cells. And at a time, it removes the potassium ions from the body. Because why? These potassium ions are very harmful to our body. And it gives the kidneys. It's removed from the kidneys. Why? Because it is a very harmful ion. But in the case of the sodium, it is useful for the unconsciousness where the BP is low. At a time it removes the K plus ions because they did not show any proper mechanism. They did not have any proper mechanism between the sodium and the potassium. Okay, that is the importance of aldosterone. From which part of the adrenal gland it secretes? Zona glomerulosa. First zone, which is also called as a mineralocorticoid. Okay, then next we will learn about the cortisol. What is that, students? Cortisol. Okay. Cortisol is a glucocorticoid. We already know about this. And also called as a life-saving hormone. Life-saving hormone. Life-saving hormone because it is a glucose substance. Okay, each and every cell of our body needs the glucose molecule for the energy. Building of our body. It needs the glucolysis, lipolysis, and proteolysis. That's why we are called as the cortisol is a life-saving hormone. What is that? Life-saving hormone. Okay, this is the importance of cortisol because it works on the glucose and maintain the our body energy metabolic rates. Okay, this is the cortisol. And last one, sex corticoids. Sex corticoids. Okay, it maintains the sexual balance and female secondary characters, means secondary sexual characters and male secondary sexual characters are maintained by the sex corticoids. Testosterone, progesterone, estrogen, like that. Okay, here it is very important for the sexual conditions, which is used for the human reproduction. Okay, this is all about the cortex region of adrenal gland. And then next we will observe the medullary regions. Medulla of adrenal gland. Okay, what will happen means here it secretes the two types of the hormones. They are nothing but epinephrine and norepinephrine. Epinephrine and norepinephrine. Also called as a fight or flight hormones. Fight or flight hormones. What are the students? Epinephrine and norepinephrine are the two hormones which are released from the medullary region of the adrenal gland. This medullary region is nothing but the, it acts like a neural control. Means it's related to the nervous system, neurohypophyte. So here, epinephrine and norepinephrine are called as the flight or flight hormone, which gives the emotions. When we are feeling happy, you give a smile. When you are angry, you feel like a angriness. Tension, high BP, low BP, all are related to this hormone. Okay, student, this is all about the medullary region of the, which one? Adrenal gland. Okay, and here, what are the disorders? What are the disorders? From this, adrenal gland, hypo or hyper secretions of the adrenal hormones. Means here, two types of the diseases we will observe. What is that? Addisons. Addisons disease. And Cushing's syndrome. These are the two disorders. Okay, what are the addiction diseases? What is the symptoms of these? Means low BP. Okay, and not proper growing muscles. Fat will be deposited on the muscles. Okay, and laziness. Like that. They are the symptoms of the addiction disease. Because here glucocorticoids or mineralocorticoids are not properly working. What will happen? Fat will be distributed into our body. Total body. Okay. Means sometimes reproductive organs are not work. Means sex steroids also they. So reproductively not proper. and muscles are sticks with the fat molecules. They all are the symptoms of the disease. Which disease? Addison's disease. Next one, Cushing's syndrome. Here, what is the difference between here? I will write the disease and here syndrome. What are the differences? Means the syndrome is nothing but the so many characteristics of the diseases. Okay, here so many characters of the so many diseases are and make the syndrome. That is the difference between disease and syndrome. Means it have a cold, cough, fever, jaundice. Is all diseases are forms and forms the syndrome. Okay, here what are the symptoms of this Cushing's syndrome? What are the symptoms? Means here abnormal growth of muscles and pendulous stomach and a buffalo hump. Okay, here what will happen means here abnormal growth of the muscles we will show in this Cushing's syndrome, and pendulous stomach means when they are walk, the stomach will look like pendular movements. పోగుతూ కనిపిస్తుంది స్టమక్. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ ద బఫెల్లో హమ్ మీన్స్ హియర్ ఫ్యాట్ విల్ బి డిపాజిటెడ్ అండ్ దర్ నెక్ రీజన్ అండ్ దే వాక్ లైక్ దిస్ మ్యాన్. బఫెల్లో హమ్ అండ్ మూన్ ఫేస్. ఓకే అండ్ రిప్రొడక్టివ్ డిజార్డర్స్. Okay, these all are the symptoms of the Cushing's syndrome. Okay, pendular stomach, moon face, and what is that? Buffalo hump, and reproductive organs are not properly worked. All are the symptoms of the syndrome. Syndrome means so many disease symptoms are make a syndrome. So not only one or two characters, so many characters we will observe in the Cushing's syndrome. Okay, students. Next, we will observe another gland, important gland, that is nothing but the pancreas. What is that? Pancreas. Where the pancreas is located? For example, it is a stomach region and it is a duodenum. Okay, in the duodenum we observe the pancreas. What is that? We observe the pancreas. This pancreas open from the common hepatic duct into the duodenum. Pancreas open by the common hepatoduct into the which one? Duodenum. Okay, here this is the location of the pancreas. In the pancreas we observe the two types of the cells, because pancreas is a mixed gland. What is that, students? Mixed gland means what? It performs the exocrine action and endocrine action. Means it have exocrine cells and endocrine cells. Okay, here outer portion of this pancreas we observe the group of the cells. They are nothing but the exocrine cells. Means they are called acini. What is that? Acini cells are perform the exocrine function in the pancreas. And this middle portion we observe the cells. They are nothing but the islets of the Langrahans. Islets of the Langrahans. Islets of the Langrahans are secrete the hormones. Hormones. But here, the acini cell secretes the enzymes. What is that, students? Enzymes means exocrine function. Here, islets of the Langerhans performs the endocrine function. In this islets of the Langerhans, we observe the different type of the cells. What are they? Means alpha cells. Okay. And beta cells. And delta cells, like that. Delta cells. Alpha cells, beta cells, and delta cells we will observe in the islets of the Langerhans. Here, alpha cells and beta cells are the important ones. Important one. Which secretes the hormones. Alpha cells and beta cells. Here, alpha cells secretes the hormone glucagon. What is that? Glucagon. And beta cell secretes the insulin. What is that, students? Insulin. Glucagon and insulin. Okay. Alpha cell secretes the glucagon. Hyperglycemic hormone. Insulin. Hypoglycemic hormone. Hypo, hyper. Why we are using these words? Means here, glucagon. Okay, students. We will observe the action of that hormone. Here, glucagon, how it work on the body. Means, for example, you take a proper food and our digestive system is releases the glucose. What is that? Glucose. After completion of the digestion, what we expect? Glucose molecule. Okay, here glucose is released. After excess of glucose is after proper utilization of the glucose, here some more portion of the glucose is there. The excess of glucose, it is fixed into the liver. Fixed into the liver by which hormone? Glucagon. This glucose is converted into glycogen. What is that? Glycogen, and fixed into the liver. That is the function of the glucagon. Hyperglycemic hormone. What is the function? Excess of glucose is converted into glycogen and it fixed into the liver. Okay, all of you understand? Next, after the, for example, you are in a fasting mode. Okay, what will happen? The glucose level of blood is low. The glucose level in the blood is low. Next, here, okay, here, insulin functions and glucagon functions. It both are the parallel, means worked on opposite positions. Worked on opposite position. What are they? Means here, for example, when you eat a food, what will happen? We discussed now. What is that? Glucose is released. Glucose is released. This excess of glucose is stored in which portion? Liver. By the insulin. By the insulin. Okay. This is the function of the insulin we're discussing now. And next, after some fasting of your body, what will happen? Means here, this excess of glucose is glycogen is converted into glucose and released into blood by the glucagon. okay, simple logic students, you did not confuse about this. For example, excess of glucose in the blood, what will happen? Insulin stores into the liver. When the glucose level is low in our blood, the glucagon again releases glucose from the liver into the blood. Glucagon into blood. Okay. And insulin from the blood into blood, from the blood. You remember these two words, you did not confuse about. Here, insulin hormone, excess of glycogen is released into the liver. But in the lower condition, what will happen? Glucagon releases the and converts the glycogen into glucose. And next, what will happen? It fits into the blood for the energy. Okay, here two words, very simple. Insulin from the blood and glucagon into blood. Blood nunchi teeskeltundi, blood loki teeskostundi. Excess of glucose. These both are the very important hormones which is